In the middle of southeast Queensland's urban sprawl lies a forest, 1,000 hectares of bushland surrounded by the homes and businesses of 1.3 million people. Karawatha Forest, on the southern outskirts of Brisbane and adjacent to the rapidly growing city of Logan, is one of the jewels in Brisbane's natural environment, one of the largest areas of remnant bushland within the city. In the Aboriginal language, Karawatha means place of pine trees, but it's so much more than a forest of pine trees. The eucalypt bushland, sandstone ridges, caves and lagoons are home to more than 320 native plant species and a refuge for some 200 species of wildlife, more than 100 bird species, more frog species than anywhere else in Brisbane. A refuge for threatened or endangered species, some not found anywhere else in Brisbane. It's also a vital part of Flinders Karawatha Corridor, 56,000 hectares extending 60 kilometres to Ipswich and beyond, the largest continuous stretch of open eucalypt bushland in southeast Queensland. Karawatha's eucalypt bushland, rocky outcrops, caves and a fertile lagoon made it a special place for the indigenous people, the Yuggera, to hunt and fish. European settlers who arrived here from the 1850s were equally dependent on the lagoons for survival, with a permanent water supply for the pioneers and their stock, and its natural resources, particularly its timber, exploited for 100 years. Old-timers Jack Heron and Bill Gross wrote their early memories for the Karawatha Forest Protection Society.
There were many thousands of feet of ironbark, yellow and red stringy bark, bloodwood, tallowood and red and scribbly gum cut from the many ridges into giant mill logs and hauled in by splendid teams of horses and bullocks on junkers and German wagons to the two sawmills.
A lot of mill timber was cut in Karawatha Park in the early 20s for building houses. During World War II, a chap by the name of Tibby Turrell dug large holes in the ground near the end of Garfield Road. These were used as charcoal pits. This charcoal was used in gas producers fitted to vehicles as petrol was rationed during the war.
Even as Karawatha was being exploited for its timber, it was always popular with locals for bushwalking and picnics.
My mother and father used to take all we children on many picnics out to Alice's Rocks and Spiny Cob, which were two ridges of huge sandstone rocks. After climbing the many rocks and playing, we would then go swimming in one of the many pristine lagoons in the area, boil the billy and have lunch. Those days the creeks were crystal clear and with plenty of fish in them.
Inevitably, the bush was being overtaken by the urban sprawl. Woodridge, which took its name from the heavily timbered ridges, was becoming a forest of homes, businesses and industry. In the 1970s, most of what is now Karawatha Forest was privately owned, but zoned by Brisbane City Council as future urban, earmarked for development.
It's a wonderful piece of natural bushland that could have easily have become, without the input from those original people who fought for its protection, it could have easily have become another several suburbs and disappeared under the urban environment.
It was in the 1970s that local councillor and former planning committee chairman Len Ardill, an avid bushwalker, saw the potential and the threat.
He already had an interest in the environment. He used to take his young son's bushwalking in a 1970 area through Tui Forest, and then he started walking through Karawatha Forest, and he started lobbying then to actually get more land for Karawatha.
He began lobbying his own council and some of the big landowners with some success to protect it as parkland for what he called the beauty and uniqueness of the area.
So then we march along another few years to 1991, and we have three ladies around a kitchen table at a house at Trinder Park really wanting to protect the forest. So they started thinking about the Karawatha Forest Protection Society. And first of all, they had a public meeting in the May of 1991, and the very first formal meeting of Karawatha Forest Protection Society was on the 4th of June 1991.
It started as a project of the Karawatha Protection Society, who wanted to preserve this area. It was a brilliant idea, and it's now our job to carry on that legacy.
Over the years, Brisbane City Council has used its bushland preservation levy to purchase and protect 1,000 hectares of bushland.
There's always opportunities to acquire additional parcels, so that's, the council has the bushland acquisition levy that reserves money to add to our estate of natural bushland, and there have been parcels recently added to that existing 900 hectare area of Karawatha Forest, and more will become, if there are more parcels available that meet the criteria that we have to maintain a natural bushland, then we'll always be looking out for those opportunities as well.
Today, Karawatha's open eucalypt forest and areas of heath, wetlands and woodlands is a haven for wildlife. But with urbanisation pressing in from all sides, one of the greatest threats to the wildlife was a major arterial road between Karawatha Forest on the south side and Currabee Bushland Reserves on the north side. The solution, fauna-friendly structures under, over and along Compton Road.
All right, well, there's a lot of different things. We've got more different structures here than anywhere else in the world in about 1 kilometre. So we've got the main thing, which is the overpass, or the land bridge, which is the big thing that's got the vegetation on top of it. On the top of the land bridge, as well as trees and shrubs, there are glider poles. There are 12 glider poles going across for gliders to glide between. But what you don't see is the underpasses underneath the road. So there are two very large ones with what we call furniture in them. So they've got a ledge, they've got a pole, and they've got a raised base so the animals can keep out of the water. And then there are three glider or possum rope bridges which go from one side of the road to the other. So they're loose things. They're only for a small suite of animals, but they get used all the time as well.
The structures have become more successful than anyone imagined.
It was really carefully constructed. They thought which trees, shrubs and grasses they should get put on them. And they took all of that stuff from the forest on either side. And so what you now have got is a reconstructed continuous forest from one side of the road to the other, exactly what you would expect. Now, what I didn't even think about was that some animals have taken to that and they live there permanently. They don't just move through. So reptiles and amphibians especially, and even some birds now are living permanently on the top of the vegetated overpass. It's become a habitat for them specifically.
A habitat and a research site. Professor Jones and his team have been tracking animals large and small through the crossing since it was built.
Studying that continuously for more than a decade, this is the most well-studied fauna overpass or fauna eco-passages in the world. And it continues to be. Every year we add new species to this thing. So it's not just really successful, it's spectacularly successful. It's being influential around the world, it's being copied around the world.
The latest jewel in the crown at Karawatha Forest is the $7 million Discovery Centre. It's been designed to inform, educate and entertain visitors to Karawatha Forest to encourage them to learn about the environment. To reconnect with the bushland, there's more than 33 kilometres of tracks throughout the 1,000 hectares of forest, a bushwalker's paradise.
Me personally, it's just basically the sereneness, the peacefulness, and also the knowledge that you've got a protection for all the animals that are there.
It's quite possible it could have gone the way of other areas and just become another couple of suburbs on the outskirts of the city. So that we've got 900 hectares of preserved bushland means we've got homes for gliders, for wallabies, for kangaroos, for frogs, for any number of birds. So it's a fantastic environment.
Karawatha Forest, saved, protected, and now officially recognised as a wildlife preserve of national significance.